Hi, I'm Dr. Drew Phillips, and I'm the High Brass Professor at Liberty University. Today, I wanted to talk about some tips and advice for the VBODA District 6 High School Audition Etude for Horn and provide a reference recording for what it should sound like. Before we begin any excerpt for any audition, we always want to observe the musical details that are already given to us, like the time signature, the key signature, and the tempo. The tempo here is marked at quarter equals 116, which is really close to quarter equals 120, which is Stars and Stripes Forever. So before I begin playing this, I imagine my pulse and my tempo in my mind, and what I would do is I would sing dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Slow that tempo down just a little bit, and you'll be in the ballpark of where you need to be with the tempo for this first section. Observe the written articulations where things are tongued and slurred with a firm articulation on everything tongued. At the end of measure 5, we see accents into a marcato in measure 6. With the accents, try and make those a bit different with weighted heavy playing, and then in measure 6, separating that marcato note slightly from the notes after it. In measure 7, we have a ritardando, and we already have almost a written in ritardando with the quarter note triplets gradually slowing down. With ritardandos, you don't want to slow down too quickly and throw the brakes on all of a sudden. So make it gradual into measure 8. Measure 8 has that fermata on the C, and fermatas don't have a defined length that you hold them for. But what I like to think is you hold them until you can't feel the pulse of where you started the piece anymore. So until you can't feel that quarter equals 116 anymore is how long approximately you can hold it for. The second section of this is quarter equals 80, which is a nice relaxed walking pace, but you don't want to go too slow on that. Try and exaggerate the dynamics in this and exaggerate the soft playing. With soft playing, instead of thinking like reserved, I like to think about putting my air and my sound far in the distance. That usually helps me to continue the vibration, continue the sound without getting response issues from trying to play too small. With connected playing, one thing that helps me is thinking about how the note endings relate to the note beginnings afterwards. So if you touch the end of one note to the front of the next note, you'll have a pretty good chance of playing really connected and making good phrases, especially in this more lyrical section. In measure 13, we approach the higher part of our range, which can present some problems. And so I like to think two things that help me with playing in the high range. First, I like to make my air exponential between the notes. We know as we play higher in the upper range, our air has to get colder and faster. And if we think in a linear progression, sometimes we don't always get to the speed we need. So I like to think of my air as compounding between each note so it exponentially gets faster instead of in a linear progression. And that helps me usually get to the velocity that I need in the upper range. The other thing I like to think of is my air out in front of me instead of directed higher, because we can't control an airstream that's above us, but we can control one that's out in front of us. So one thing I like to think about in the upper range is I like to think about any higher pitch grabbing it aggressively with my air, and almost like that pitch is a balloon that wants to keep rising, I keep it down. That allows my top lip to continue vibrating and I can get response instead of pressing into it with too much pressure and getting lack of response in that. The last thing in this section is in measure 16. Don't get too soft too quickly. Make that diminuendo from 15 to 16 gradual all the way down to piano. The last section of this is really similar to the beginning with the same tempo and same style of playing. In measure 20, I like to separate that B natural from the D just a little bit because of the syncopation, letting the people listening to it know that you recognize it is a different rhythm than bar 4 when it first appeared. At the end of this, stay strong from 22 all the way to the end. And again, let that ritardando and rallentando in measure 23 occur naturally. Don't throw on the brakes too soon. Thank you. any questions, my contact info is in the description box below. And best wishes and happy practicing as you prepare your audition.